This evening, southern Beirut is still smoldering. After what residents call the most intense bombing in nearly 20 years on a cluster of high-rises and the bunker beneath them, killing Hassan Nasrallah, Hezbollah's leader for the last three decades. The group confirmed his death on its TV channel after the Israel Defense Forces posted on social media, Hassan Nasrallah will no longer be able to terrorize the world. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu.
At the start of the week, I came to the conclusion that the intense blows the Israeli military struck Hezbollah within the past days, these blows will not be enough. Nasrallah's assassination was an essential condition to achieving the goals we set.
Nasrallah was Hezbollah's commander and communicator in chief. His charisma made him powerful in Lebanon and one of the Middle East's most influential figures. He inspired Shia followers with fiery speeches and the sacrifice of his own son fighting Israel. Even if for years he has only spoken remotely. For Iran, Hezbollah became its key proxy, and Nasrallah anchored its axis of resistance, a close confidant of Iran's supreme leader, Ayatollah Khamenei. In Tehran today, the regime's supporters vowed revenge.
We have heard the message clearly with the killing of Nasrallah. Israel will be destroyed. Israel is finished for sure. The oppressor, Israel, will go.
But in southern Beirut, the smoke hasn't yet cleared, and residents are beginning an overwhelming cleanup. Many have fled, 100,000 just in the last week, some from Lebanon to Syria, despite its civil war. They're too scared to spend the night in their southern Lebanon homes, so they sleep outside, longing for a safer present and future.
May God protect the people who were displaced from their homes and those who fled the south and all the areas affected by the war. May God protect them.